Day three in Jamaica. Today is June 6, 2015. My name is Keith Ray Elam with Hemp Publishing Company, aka The Hippie Terrorist. Yeah. I'm terrorizing Blue Mountains of Jamaica. Well, today's title of this video is called What to Expect in Jamaica and in Blue Mountain. There's no internet service in Blue Mountain. You can buy a phone in Jamaica and be able to get internet service. You can pick up cell phone service up here and get internet through that. That's the only way you're going to get an internet up here. I'm at Wildflower Lodge Hostel. Hell, I was going to show you the sign, but Wildflower Lodge, whatever it is. June, it's cold up here at nighttime. You gotta have a jacket. And they say December gets very cold up here. Now everybody up here, I have a jacket off. I'm freezing my ass off at night. But everybody else has shirts on. They're used to the weather. But I would say it's probably, 60 degrees right now. Somewhere around there. It's pretty chilly in the morning right now. Now, if you did like I did and come up here without no tour guide, what to expect in Jamaica? They're going to charge you $81 just to take you on the foothills down there. And then you got to cook to the police station. The police station will call up these guys and they'll come down and pick you up for $50, around $50. And then he's charged me for 23 days. I jewed him down. He wanted 28, and then he dropped it down to 26. And then he goes, give me $2,000. So that's about $200 that I'm paying for this. You guys bring a shower bag with you if you come to Jamaica. Because that. In May and June, they don't have water up here in Blue Mountain. What to expect in Blue Mountain? They don't have water in here. And they say it's the rainy season, May and June, but they're telling me, no, the rainy season's in the wintertime, just like in the United States. So what the internet tells you and what the people tell you are two different stories. What to expect in Jamaica, too. You only have 3 months visa when you come in Jamaica. So don't listen to the videos that say you got 6 months. And then go buy a return airline ticket. Which you have to have a return airline ticket out of Jamaica. They will ask you that. What to expect in Jamaica. You're going to have to turn around and have an address where you're going at. Which I didn't. I just said Blue Mountain. Wrote a name down, one of the hostels I've seen on the internet. Said, I'm going up there. It doesn't have an address. And that's how I was able to get away with it. So I bought my airline ticket in December. I'm stuck here. But they told me I have to go to Kingston and ask for an extension. And they will give me an extension. Costs a little bit of money. I don't know how much. But I'm going to stay up here as long as I can. Not up here. What to expect on Blue Mountain? Ha, 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 ha. Ha, ha, ha. A lot of things. There's no stores up here. No stores up here. No internet up here. There is a bus line, but you're going to have to walk like about 10, 15 minutes, they said, to a bus station. Which it costs like about $1.50 to get to the next town. And they said the next town is Baluma or Patuna, I don't know, I'm not that good. Patoon. And they say there's an ATM there, hopefully, with internet service. So, I gotta go there as soon as I can. What to expect in Jamaica? Don't come up here with any money expecting you're gonna live good. Make sure you got $1,000 in your pocket, and then you can just... I didn't come with $1,000, I came with less. I came with a lot less. What to expect in Blue Mountain? There's no marijuana growing up here, alright? There's no marijuana like everybody advertises on YouTube. I met all the people around here so far. They only grow coffee bean up here. They say all the marijuana is by St. Mary, St. Elizabeth, St. Andrews, Nornchill, Nigel, there's a lot. But they say up here, there's no marijuana growing. So you're gonna, looks like I'm able to get a pound for about $80, $90 up here. But it's shitty ass weed. I think it's the government's weed. That's what I tell them. This shit looks like the government's weed down in Mexico. And they, no, man, we're going to bring some good shit up here. Okay. Now, what to expect on Blue Mountain? There's only three hostels. There's one there. I don't know how many people they hold. I haven't seen nobody there either. All right. They got a water tank up there. They do have two water tanks on their land. One there and one over there. Which, my hostel I'm staying at. Now, the restaurants. I'm paying these people $10 a night. And I'm feeding them. I'm feeding their family, but they're cooking me dinner. I don't wash the dishes. Every night I get dinner. Now, they say there is a store that is on the other side of the mountain, but you have to drive over there. And they say it's walking distance, but it'll take you a long time. But, this owner drives those people from that town up to there, to their store. And I was able to buy some sweet bread, something that I can eat in the morning time with my fruit. Now, May, June, they said there's a lot of harvesting. One of the coffee bean farmers, I asked him if he can bring some fruit up, and he brought me some grapefruit, some three other types of fruits. Hell, I don't know what they are, but they're grown locally up here. And so, what to expect in Blue Mountain? They're going to say, hey, I'll take you to a hike. And this guy took me to a hike, probably. Not even 10, 15 minutes, which I would have ended up doing by myself anyway. I wouldn't need no tour guide. To the end of the road until it goes up to Blue Mountain. And he comes back, and I gave him some money thinking he was going into town for me. But he ended up pocketing that money for the fruit that he gave to me. Which the kid here ate most of the fruit, the little kid that lives here, the little boy. So if you guys come up here, expect the little kid to be in your hair all day long, in everything you have. You know how children are, hell, we were like that too, got our hands on everything. So, he said, well, you know, for the fruit and this tour guide that I gave to you, which he only showed me two trees and the fruit where he was picking the fruit from, which there's no way I could go up there and pick the fruit. He charged me, he took $10 from me. So, don't give people money and expect them to do something for you, and then they ask you, hey, let's go do this and let's go do that. They're going to charge you for your services. Now, this guy, he hasn't really charged me nothing. He's gotten some things for me that I needed, and he went to town. And I don't know if I paid him gas money or not. I gave him a little bit of money. But he says everything's cool, so I take their word for it. What they expect in Blue Mountain, you're going to have pine trees here, guys, like in my last video. Which, I feel like I'm at home when I'm in pine trees. That's the reason why I really didn't hesitate about staying up here 23 days with no food, no water. They told me there was a walking distance to stores when they first took me up here. Because I said, I need a store every day. I need to buy my vegetables. Don't worry, gringo. You'll be okay up here. Yeah. I don't feel like walking over the side of the mountain, down the side of the mountain, just to get to a store. But I'm going to survive for a few days. Luckily, the farmer did bring me enough bananas. Because I've eaten bananas before down in Mexico. That's how I survived during the daytime. Just eat a few bananas. And which you guys can do that too. They say bananas grow here year-round, but I don't think in December the bananas are going to be too good. Because in Mexico, the bananas are not good in December in Mexico. I don't eat bananas in December. Nor January. What to expect? I don't know what else I can tell you folks that you need to know. But I'll repeat it. No electricity, no internet, no stores, no water. You gotta actually use a bucket to flush your toilet. Which the first day I was up here, I just went out in the wilderness. I've only been here 2 nights here. It's been only 2 nights here. And the first night I just went out in the bushes like I've done for many, many times in my lifetime and just shit with the bears. But they say there's no bears up here, no lions, no tigers, no foxes. They say the only thing you gotta fear up here is a big old huge squirrel that nobody eats, but they kill. That kills the chickens. There is a couple of mosquitoes up here, so I think I'm gonna try to figure out a way I can set up my hammock inside my bedroom. And just sleep inside of it, because I had a netting that I gave to my daughter thinking I wasn't going to need it. Because I wasn't going to expect to sleep in a hostel. I wasn't wanting to sleep in any bed. On any bed, in any room. But he gave me a pretty good price where it's like, you know, I was expecting to sleep outside for that price. So, yeah, I'll give you that money. Now, there's a place where I met these two growers. Well, I met this guy on the jet. And I'll let you look at the view instead of my ugly, dirty face. It's kind of cloudy. But this guy, he goes, where are you going at Blue Mountain? He goes, you won't like Blue Mountain. And I said, why? And he goes, you won't like it, gringo. He goes, I know people like you. I've lived almost all my life in the United States, but I was born in Jamaica, but I've seen all of Jamaica. He was a teacher, Boston, Massachusetts. Yeah, man, he was a told me of some good stories. He's a smart motherfucker, too. But he was a teacher for like 20 years in the United States. Smart motherfucker. I said, you know what? I'd sure like to have you for my teacher. You would have taught me how to survive in life instead of how to become a failure in life, like all the other teachers in the United States teaches their children. He goes, yeah, you want to know what? He goes, I got a good heart. He goes, I love everybody. I don't hate everybody like the teachers do in the schools in the United States do. I looked at him and said, yeah, okay. So he told me, he goes, you go to Strawberry Fields by St. Mary's. So these guys are sitting around there and I said, hey man, do you guys know where Strawberry Fields is out here in Jamaica? Because apparently nobody knows the place. He said, buddy, we're from there. I said, say what? You from there? I said, yeah, we're going to go back here in about a week. I says, well, you're going to go back there and me going to follow in your asses. And you're going to go, what the fuck are you doing behind me, man? Get the fuck out of here, you white boy. Go home. Go home from where you came from. I said, I'm not following. I'm going to fucking follow your guys' asses where you're going to go at. I said, better yet, I'll tell you what. You guys showed me where Strawberry Fields is at, where I can set up my tent, because there's a tent compound down there where people just set out their tents and they're just loving life. You pay a little bit of money to let squat out there on their land, but there's a whole bunch of people from around the world setting in these tents. Now that's what this guy was telling me in the mountains. And he goes, I married a lady just not far from there, but I know the people who work on the ranch. And one of them's picked me up today, and he said, I'm going to give you his telephone number because you just can't go up there and squat on their land. You have to know somebody to get there on this piece of private property, he said. He said, there's other places you can go at, but he said, this one area, he goes, you're going to have to know the people because it's only a group of Rastafires that live there, the true Rastafires that live off the land. And he goes, you go there and you can eat off the land. I said, okay. And he says, it's only a 40-minute drive to the coast, something like that. And he says, you're up in the mountains. So I told these guys, I said, I'll tell you what, I'll buy your guys' bus tickets to get your asses home. But you're going to help me find a place to live at down there for a month. That's all I want to stay down there is 1 month, get my fucking ass out of there, and go somewhere else. And they agreed to it. And this one guy tells me he owns land, his parents do, that I can stay on his land. And he named off so many types of mongos he had on his land. He told me he had everything you could survive on his property there. And then he tells me another thing. He goes, I'm going to take you to the biggest marijuana field on Jamaica's land. And I said, say what, buddy? I'll even pay you money to show me that. Oh, man. Is it nice meeting strangers on the road and just offering them a little bit of marijuana and just sit there and let them get high? And you become best friends with them for the rest of your lives? It's happened to me before. It's happened to me many places around the world. But you gotta treat each other like a human being, man. Ask them questions about themselves. Don't talk about yourself. They'll ask you about you. Eventually. But I was able to get, I was able to scrounge up about an ounce of weed for about $10, okay, everybody? An ounce of weed will last me a couple days up here. Well, not providing, because nobody has marijuana up here. So if you guys are marijuana smokers and you come to Blue Mountain, expect one thing. You're going to be providing joints to everybody that shows up here. Now, the hostel that I've shown you is the only hostel where all the local farmers come up here. And they only stay up here a few weeks. Some of the people only come up here for a few weeks to work, to pick the berries or the cocoa, the coffee bean berries, and they leave. That's the end of their job. And so you're going to meet a lot of people from all over Jamaica that are coming up here. It's very interesting, but they hang out right there at nighttime. And all this whole area is just one owned by one company. And they, I think they are employing like 13 farmers. I think that's what they said. That's employed up here. And about half of them come down here and they smoke their marijuana. They all smoke marijuana. They all smoke ganja. The owner doesn't smoke. The wife doesn't smoke. But they don't care about you smoking weed. So I think this is the best hostel. If you really want to get to know everybody, because I've seen the videos, and it doesn't have no hangouts where everybody just gathers together. And that's what I want to do, is to get around a whole bunch of people. Now, trust me, I didn't see this place on video. Nobody's made a YouTube video about this place yet. I don't know why, because there's not much here to brag about, but you know, if you want to get to meet the people like I want to do, yeah, you can't ask for a better spot to come up here in Blue Mountain. I don't think so. You know, it's not the best living quarters, but, you know, for $10, you're feeding the family every night. You're getting a very good hot meal, the best Jamaican chicken I've eaten. It's all fresh local chicken. Rice with broccoli. They grow their broccoli here, but it's real small broccoli. Really small broccoli. But their soil is very rocky. And I told them, man, how they can get rid of the rocks, man. Put new compost. I'm trying to speak another language. And, as you can see, they got some vegetables growing there. But that, you know, I brought some seeds to give to some local farmers so they can make a lot of money. I'm not going to give it to them. I'm just going to give these guys a tip. Let them smoke all my weed. Yeah, I'm going to drag my seeds somewhere else, because I want to be able to, if I have to survive in Jamaica, I want to be able to grow on somebody's soil, have a nice garden, show them how to grow. Of course, they already know how to grow. A chicken up here runs about $4.50. I bought some shampoo, some toilet paper, some soap, and a six pack of this goddamn fucking malt drink, sweet non-alcoholic drink that this, I thought was beers. Said, yeah, grab a six pack, hop in the taxi. Taxi driver hands me one. I take one drink, spit it out. What the fuck is this shit you're drinking? But everything cost me like 20 $22. All right, $22. So I don't know how much the shampoo and soap is, but you know, they won't let you carry it in luggage, but you can probably put it down board, bring your shampoo and your soap if you come up here. But once you get into town, some areas, I know it's going to be cheaper, but it seemed like everything, everywhere I did business at. Now, like all videos, all the Jamaicans know where the marijuana is at. And they don't smoke marijuana. A lot of taxi cab drivers don't smoke marijuana. Matter of fact, the taxi cab driver that brought me up so far up here, and he took me to Forest Park. It's on the internet. Now, there's this internet that these people from Switzerland walked the whole trail of Blue Mountain from one town all the way up, and they passed right by this road. They hiked from Blue Mountain down here. They hiked all the way down this mountain, hiked all the way over down to the valley, hiked back up in another part, and there's a part called Forest Park. And they stayed there. And when I pulled up, I told the lady, I says, you know your hostel's on YouTube. It's very famous. She goes, yeah, I heard that my hostel's on YouTube. So she knew about it. She wanted $90 a night. 90 US dollars a night. I choked. I said, say what? No. Well, I looked at the driver and I said, man, come on, man, what are you doing to me? He goes, well, you didn't tell me the prices you wanted. I said, I want something affordable, $10 a night. So this bus driver, or this taxi cab driver, drops me off at the police station just to get directions. And I walk up to the police officers and they says, we'll take care of you. And I said, what's going on? I was talking to the taxi cab driver, and he goes, you can stay with the police, and they will take care of you. Or you can come back to Kingston with me, and I'll show you a place where you can survive at. But he goes, it's not going to be a safe place for you. And I looked at the police, and I looked at him, and I says, you have a good day. I'll trust the police up here. So they start asking me questions. Where are you from? What occupation do you do? What are you doing up here in Blue Mountain? And I looked at the cops and says, I want to go find the marijuana growers. And they looked at me and they said, what? I says, hell yeah, I want to look for marijuana up here. And they just became silent. And I said, you know what, guys? You need to change your ways of thinking in life about marijuana. Because some people need marijuana to live in life. It's a medicine. It's not a drug. It's a medicine. And they all looked at each other and they says, yeah, you're right. And I says, well, you need to treat your brothers, the ones who smoke marijuana, you need to just leave them alone. They're not criminals. They're not going to harm nobody. But, you know, I ended up drinking beers with all of them. I convinced all of them to have a beer with me. And I sat down, and when I left, I gave them $20, which is quite a bit of money, to get them food. And they didn't want the money. And I said, listen, I want you to have some food on me, because I did it in Mexico, and I'm going to do it here. I want you guys to respect other tourists when they come through, the ones who smoke marijuana like I do. Respect us as a brother, okay? Because we're not doing no harm. We're just going out and just helping people out on this. And I told them about the seeds that I have. I wanted to find a farmer up here and be able to plant my seeds in case I have to survive in Jamaica. I said, I want to be able to live off the land that I'm living on. And he goes, well, let me look at the seeds, man. I said, man, you know what? I don't want to dig the seeds out. Luckily, my driver shows up. And I says, and the cop's looking at me and says, there's your ride, man. And I looked at the cops and I looked at the driver and I said, "You know where to find a whole bunch of marijuana for me?" I said, "Hell with the goddamn police, man. Don't listen to them. Don't give a shit what they think, what I'm saying to you. Do you know where you can get some marijuana before I get in your goddamn Jeep? Because I need it to survive in life." And the cops all looking at each other. And the guy just, with a red, his black face turned red. And he goes, with a smile on his face, he goes, "I can help you out." Right in front of the cops. I just said, "You're my man." I said, "Goodbye, cops. I think he's going to take care of me very well in life." Cops said, "Don't worry, man. You will be taken care of up here." So if that's what happens, it was Mavis Bank is where the place where the police department's at. And so they don't have a bank. They don't have an ATM. So you have to drive through Mavis, apparently, to get to the next town where they have the ATM and the internet service. But they said it's walking distance to the bus, and you can go back, and you can even go to Kingston, and they take you right back up in here. If you guys really want to know something important, which, if I would have known that, I would have taken a bus up here, and instead of paying $130, which I wanted to go find a bus, but there was no taxi cabs around. Alright, guys. The taxi cab service is called Putin, I think, or Puta. Puti, or something like that. And if you walk out of the Jamaican airport, they're the first place right as you go out the door of the where the everybody hangs out at outside of the airport, and they're sitting right there, so you can negotiate with them. Tell them you want to go up to the very top, which I don't think their vans would come up here. I had a four, everybody up here has a four-wheel drive, okay? So I think that's as far as they will deliver you to. So just walk up to the local police department and says, "You know what, I seen a video on YouTube. This American had a beer with you guys, and you acted really friendly, and you enjoy everybody's company on this earth." Call up that owner that white boy called up, you guys called up one day. They'll call him up. They're friends. That's nice to have friends like that. Really, it's nice to have friends like that, but the local growers will provide you 50-cent bags of marijuana all day long to you. And it's enough to roll about two joints, three joints, little teeny, and they roll little small joints up here. So, at first I was rolling these big old fat joints, and everybody was rolling these skinny joints, and after a while I was rolling the skinny joints along with the skinny joints everybody else was rolling. But they roll their joints weird. They roll it in like a cone shape. And on the very bottom it's just really skinny. I can't roll like that, but I need to learn how they roll like that, because I was going, your first year marijuana tastes good, and the very last is very harsh when it's really thick on the end. I said, the way you guys are smoking it, you guys are actually, when it gets to the end, there's not much of that harshness inside that weed, and they're all laughing, ha 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 ha, yeah man. What to expect in Jamaica? They speak a language you will not ever understand. The whole world will never understand these people's tongues unless you're an ancestor of Africa and you was raised around African people. They speak their native tongues from over 200-300 years ago that they still speak today. And I told him, I said, "You don't teach the white man your tongue. You don't teach anybody that wants to learn your language. You keep that language a secret." and they talk in front of me, and I hear a word or two that you'll catch in that they use in English, like quart, like pound. No, they call a pound up here a punta. A punt. That's how they pronounce a pound up here. Oh, by the way, I had a dream right before I woke up this morning. I was sitting across the street where I was living at in Jamaica, and the cops come busting in the doors. And I'm with my friend, and I says, ha, 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 ha. All I have is a less than 2 ounces of marijuana. And I ran upstairs to the police. And, you know, they said, hey, we got your marijuana up here. And I said, yeah, well, I got my medical marijuana card. I don't think you guys can do anything with me. And they says, where's your medical marijuana card? And I went to look for it, and that's when I woke up. And I couldn't go back to sleep after that dream. God, it was vividly. Man, I seen the police, man. The uniforms, the black faces. One had glasses. The guy that was talking to me had glasses on. Round glasses. It's weird how you have dreams like that. Take your dreams seriously. I do. Because some days my dreams do come true. I woke up this morning. I says, I hope that dream doesn't come true. You know, I was expecting it in Mexico. I used to hide my marijuana. And one day I realized, you know what? They're going to bring the dogs in anyway. Just fucking set the shit right out in front of you. So if they do come in the house, they see it. Everybody else sees your marijuana on the table. So that's the way it is in life. But in Jamaica, they passed a new law. Each person can have 5 plants of marijuana. And the soil up here is no good to grow marijuana. They do grow plants, but they're not big. So I told them, I told the local farmer growers, I says, get off your asses, go find you 5-gallon buckets, put some holes in the bottom, put some nice dirt inside there, and stick those buckets next to all your cocoa, your coffee bean plants, everywhere. 5 plants there, walk over the side of the other area, put 5 more plants, walk over to another area, put 5 more plants, walk over to an area, put 5 more plants, and this cops and soldiers are going to come up to you, and they're going to catch you with 5 plants. And you're going to get the fuck out of here, man. Go find you a fucking another fucking group of people to harass. I said, you make a lot of money up here off the tours. I'm a devil, trust me. And I even told them how to grow marijuana the right way in life. They were all ears. All these growers. Trust me, I'm a terrorist, man. I'm here to terrorize every government on earth. Even Jamaica's government. Corrupt the police. Corrupt the government officials. Hell yeah. If you know how to do it the right way, like I know how to do it. You can live anywhere on earth if you have the money. Don't have to have the money, you just have to have the skills. But after me dealing with police for 54 years of my life, soon becoming 55 here on June 14th, 2015, I know how to sweet talk cops. And I know how to piss them off, too, where they throw me in jail. But sometimes I like pissing cops off. Tell them they're a fucking piece of shit on this fucking earth, what they do to us. Listening to their masters and obeying their laws that they create for us to try to obey in life. Remember, if you compete with the government officials, like selling cocaine and heroin like the government officials do, they'll throw your ass in jail. Along with the marijuana. This one guy was telling me this story last night in Jamaican, and I was able to hear half of what he said. But he was talking the Jamaican tongue. But if you listen closely, even this guy on the airplane, he says, you listen closely, you can understand what they say, because they slip up and they'll say some English words to you.